Hey guys, welcome back to No Catch Name. It's me, Ella. It's been a few days. I had every intention, I feel like I forgot to put some hair up, to make Whip Wednesday video. Yeah. And I ended up being super busy. She's over there. And then I meant to do it on Thursday, and time just flew by. So now it's Friday, and I'm just going to do a little update. It's not a whip day. But, so I have been working on a couple of things. So I'll just show you first. The other day I made a little flower pattern, which is behind me, the first one I made. So I did, when I was sitting outside with the kids, I made three more of them. So here's one. This is like, I think this is red heart, pale yellow. And the back is spring green. And this is a scrap of a multicolor yarn. I had to weave in the end. But there's one of them. And then this is all red heart colors. The lighting's bad. I didn't bring my big light in here. Pale yellow again and spring green again, and this is I think Pretty in Pink by Red Heart. This one turned out a little bit bigger because I think this is a scrap of a I Love This Yarn. And then I made this one. This is Hot Pink by Red Heart, and then the same two colors again. Also got to weave in the tail. So I got three more of those made. And then I went to Dollar Tree and I got one of those little metal stake things that you stick in the ground, and then you can hang like garden flags on it. I've always wanted one of those, and I've just never really gotten one. And I don't know how good that one is, like how sturdy it is. I haven't tried it with anything on it yet. It's still over here, so I keep looking over there. But I have a bunch of garden flag patterns by Heidi Yates. She made a whole lot, and I got like almost all her patterns pretty much. So I did start working on that, and I started on, it's called the Buggy Garden Flag, I think. It is paid for pattern. But she used to, I don't know if she does anymore, but she used to give away her patterns like all the time. That's how I got almost all of them, almost for free. Or during events, you can buy like, you pay like $7 and you get like 11 patterns or something like that. Anyways, so I made that before years ago, the Valentine's Day themed one. It looks like a ladybug with hearts and stuff. But also including that pattern is how to make a bumblebee one. So I thought it'd be cute to make a bumblebee one to hang up outside for spring. And then I'm going to make another one that I have, a watermelon one, for summer, when it gets closer to summertime. Anyways, I did start it, but I immediately messed up. I read just a little bit of the beginning instructions. I printed them out, and I didn't read enough of them. So you're supposed to chain a certain amount and then single crochet back into it, and then you're supposed to start doing half double crochets. I did not do that. I did a single chain, then I did a whole bunch of single crochets. So you're only supposed to do like 25 rows of half double crochet, but because I did single crochet, I had to kind of like double it. So here's my base of it. This is a part that's supposed to be a half double crochet. So it's just denser, you know, it's got a denser fabric to it. So I did just add more rows. I don't even know how many. I just did it until it looked about the size in the picture. So this is Red Heart, light blue. And then the hangers that will go, that'll attach to the blue and go over the little pole, I made in spring green, which this is all the spring green I have left. I gotta get some more spring green. These up here is glowworm, which was gifted to me by a couple different people, and I don't have any more skeins of spring green. This is my last scrap ball, but I'm planning on going on to Joanne's tomorrow, Saturday, yeah. And if they have a yarn sale, I might pick up some if they have any. Anyways, back to this. So I made the three hangers. They'll go kind of like this. So there are three of them. So here's one, two, and three. I didn't make all three of them. So I got the base, like the sky, and the hangers. And then on the hangers, they'll be folded with the blue. There's little daisies, which I got all three of the daisies. You put them on the hanger like that. I haven't woven in any of the ends. So I did make the three little daisies. And this is just Red Heart white and some more of that pale yellow. I had a little scrap ball. I was trying to use it all up. So I got three daisies, the three hangers, and the base. And then I started on the bee's wing. Because at the time, I was sitting in the living room. You want these flowers? At the time, I was sitting in the living room. And the next part of the pattern was to work on the bee's body. And I didn't have yellow with me. Because for this or here, I had just a little tiny scrap ball that I was using to make those flowers. So I needed to come in here and get some yellow and some black, but I didn't want to do that because I was in there, you know, I was in my moment crocheting and stuff. So I just picked up the white that I had and I made one wing. So now I got to make another one just like this for the bee's wings. And then I think after that, I just have to make his head and his body and sew it all together. And there's a little bit of stitching on. I think there's little hearts too. I didn't print that part of the pattern out. I'll have to look on the computer to get that. But because there's little antennas, you stitch them, and then the little hearts are at the end of it. So I'm working away on that. Are you throwing my flowers?
They're in the floor.
Let's see if I can pick them up. So that is what I've been working on the last few days. Something over here is making like a squeaky noise as it moves. But I haven't been crocheting anything else. I've been trying to just keep it simple stuff. That's why I wanted to start these little flowers, because I wanted to be able to pop out things easy. I do need to start my April Halloween projects. I already have it picked out. I just haven't started making it yet. For the three immigrant weeks. And then I've just been sewing and stuff. So there are some bags in the shop if you want to check it out. There's still some drawstring bags, I think a couple totes. And everybody who had ordered, I got them right here. I'm going to package them up today and drop them off at the post office tomorrow. I used to be able to go to the post office throughout the week, but with Devin's new work schedule, he gets off work after they already close. So I can't go to the post office anymore every day. I can only go on Saturdays. So all these orders from this past week will be getting dropped off tomorrow morning. And then if anybody makes any orders today, I can drop them off tomorrow. But if you make orders after today, it won't be until next Saturday that I can get them in the post office. Unless I get my mom or someone to stop by on her way somewhere and drop them off for me. But anyways, yeah, so that's what I've been working on. Got the orders here. Already got everything printed that I have to get, you know, the slips and all that. I just got to sit down and package them up. And I want to work on this little bee thing and get it done so I can hang it outside before spring is over. And then I'll work on my Halloween ones, maybe. So I need to get them done. What is today? Today's the April 21st, so I'm running out of time to get everything, you know, to keep it all in the right month, because I like trying to stay on schedule. But yeah, so I guess I'll hop off here. I'm going to go join us tomorrow, like I said. I'm going to get sewing stuff, but I'll probably look at the yarn. So if I buy anything interesting, I'll share it with you guys. And I guess that's it. I'm going to hop off here. Let me know what you guys have been working on lately. And I will see you guys in another video. Bye, guys.